I remember you posted a video, Amir posted it, one of you, maybe you, I don't remember, about his hand speed. He threw, I think, 16 or 18 punches in 3 seconds? Was it something like that?
Yeah.
I mean, have you ever...
He's definitely got hand speed, but he's beginning to understand his hand speed. And, you know, there's a difference between a combination and a flurry. There's a difference between pit-patting and, you know, punching through the target. So he's beginning to understand the concepts of combinations and hand speed. Hand speed doesn't mean I can break off 8 punches in a row and only one was effective. Hand speed means I might break off 2 and both were effective. So as long as he understands his hand speed, it's like having the best automatic weapon in the world and don't know how to use it. So as long as he understands how to use those weapons, he can only get better.
Devin Alexander is very, very talented. Kevin Cunningham, a great trainer.
Yes.
He's not only with Devin, he had success with other fighters.
Yes.
What concerns you about Devin Alexander, or what do you look from him? What does he do right? What does he do wrong?
Well coached and very determined ever since he was a little fella. He's very determined, and I think that no one can take that away from him. You know, when I used to sing when he was 12 and 13 years old, you know, you could just see that one day he was going to be a world champion. So, and not only has he been to the mountaintop, I mean, he proved he can get back there in 2 divisions. So anybody who's been to the mountaintop and knows how to get back is not someone that you take lightly. So my hat goes off, my respect goes off to Team Alexander.
I know, Coach, you never like to put a fight before this fight. You're dealing with the task at hand, December 13, Devin Alexander. One fight that I'd like to see now that Golden Boy and Topuric are working together, Amir Khan, Manny Pacquiao. What do you think about that? Possible?
Well, anything's possible. And I think that would probably be a great fight, you know, if it ever took place. I know that they've sparred a lot of rounds, but fighting is not like sparring. And listen, you know, Manny Pacquiao's at the top of his game, and Amir Khan is trying to get where Manny has been. So it only makes sense, if all the elements are right, that, you know, one day they possibly could fight.
Another big possible fight, because top of the pyramid, Floyd Money Mayweather, Amir Khan. Some people tell me Amir Khan beats Floyd because of the speed, because of the boxing. He's going to make it difficult for Floyd. Other people say otherwise. What do you think of that fight, if it goes down?
You know, I think Floyd has done things in boxing and proven things in boxing that one would be foolish to get caught off in the opinions of others when it comes to fighting him. So far, every time he stepped in the ring, he's found a way. And I think that you have to respect that. And if you do get an opportunity to fight him, you have to prepare diligently. You know, you have to understand what you're up against. You have to understand your weaknesses in that fight, your strengths in that fight. Yes, Amir has tremendous speed and youth, which could be very well to his advantage. Floyd has experience and also has speed, but he has a boxing IQ, and he also has that boxing experience. So sometimes a young man can, on a given night, can take it to another level because of his youth and go fight way above his head because of his youth. And that right there could be a big difference in a fight, particularly one that's projected to be close. So, I mean, the main thing is that I would like to see Amir test himself.